This is one of the hardest prisons in Minecraft, and I will be attempting to escape it, starting now. The second I spawned in, I looked around. I was in a bedrock box stuck behind iron bars. There was another room, so I broke the iron bars and walked into the other room. In this room, there's a chest out of my reach, a lava fall, a crafting table, and a hole, which I assumed was where I needed to go. First, I checked behind the lava and I found a chest. The chest had 3 blackstone and a blaze powder in it. I knew I could craft blackstone slabs, but I decided to check the rest of the room first. While searching, I found a barrier block in the middle of the room. I looked around and I ended up finding more, and I realized I could parkour on them. After jumping to the first block, there was no more blocks to jump to. From here, I could use the blackstone and make it to the chest, but I decided not to because I had blaze powder, which hints to me having to make a brewing stand. It ended up not mattering though, because I tried jumping towards the chest and I was able to open it for a second. This gave me everything I needed to make a fire resistance potion. I drank the potion and started to climb up the lava. At the top of the lava, there was another chest and it gave me an ender pearl. The only thing I could think of using an ender pearl for was to enter the tunnel, so I grabbed the crafting table in case I needed it later and threw the pearl into the tunnel. At the end of the tunnel, there were 2 different directions I could go, each leading to a different room. The first room had nothing in it except for a hole in the roof that was out of my reach. The second room had a floor made of ice that looked like it had something underneath it. I decided to drop into the second room because it seemed more promising. Under the ice, I could see lava and magma blocks really far down. I knew I couldn't lift this fall, so I needed a way to get down. The obvious way down was the ice, but if I break the ice, nothing is going to happen because there isn't a block underneath it. Luckily, I picked up the crafting table from earlier, and I was able to use that to get water. I swam down the water and ended up in another room. This room was decorated with terracotta on the walls and lava and magma blocks on the floor. Unfortunately, there were barrier blocks preventing me from breaking out. Because of this, I assumed there had to be a missing barrier somewhere. After checking most of the room, I finally found one that was missing, and under it there was a chest with 3 ladders, a trapdoor, and flint. I realized there was nothing else in this room, but I remembered the room on the left of the tunnel had a hole in the roof, and I was pretty sure 3 ladders would allow me to reach it. So I decided to climb back up the water and use the crafting table and trapdoor to get back into the tunnel. I dropped into the other room, and luckily 3 ladders was enough to get through the hole. When I made it to the top, I had entered a hallway with a bunch of different things. There was an armor stand with a sword and a cobweb on top, obsidian in the shape of a nether portal, and a hole in the roof that I had no way of accessing. When I got further down the hallway, I found another room with a giant pit of lava. There was a room on the left, a pig across from me, and a big hole in the wall exactly on the other side, and more cobwebs. I grabbed the sword from the armor stand and broke the cobwebs, making sure none of them fell in the lava. I checked my crafts, and the only thing I could make was a block of wool, so I did that. I used the block of wool to parkour to the room on the side and found a chest with a carrot and a saddle. I was very familiar with what I could do with these items because of this video, and I used the carrot to lure the pig towards me. Once it walked over, I jumped and landed the pig clutch. Now I was on the other side, but all I had was a crafting table and I still couldn't get to the next room because it was 2 blocks up. While trying to figure out what to do, I found a secret chest above the hole and it had 3 sticks. I went back over to the crafting table and made the only thing it let me make, a fishing rod. Even with a fishing rod, I still didn't know what to do. The only thing I could think of was fishing in the lava. But fishing the lava turned out to be a waste of time, and now I was stumped. I decided to check the hole again, but this time I checked in F5. I was hoping I would find another chest, but instead I saw a horse all the way at the bottom. If you didn't know, you can use fishing rods to pull mobs towards you. So now I knew how to get down, but I still had to be careful that I didn't die of fall damage getting off the horse. So I brought the horse up, and luckily, I was able to survive the fall, and I made it to the next room. This next room had 2 hoppers on both sides of me and a random button on the wall. Pressing the button did nothing, so I decided to open the hoppers. The first one had an emerald with a sign above it that said you might need this later. And the other hopper had steak, a golden apple, a blast protection 4 chestplate, and a TNT. Now that I had all these items, I still needed to find a way to make a 3 block jump. If you've played Bed Wars before, you might be familiar with the TNT jump, where a TNT explosion is used to boost a player. So, I used the button to activate my TNT and jumped over the wall. In this part of the room, there were 3 new things: a hole in the roof, a dispenser, and some sort of hot tub. There were signs between the water and the lava, but if anything was under the lava, it was too far to reach. The items in my inventory weren't of much use either. At this point, I was stumped until I found this terracotta on the roof. The terracotta was the same dimensions as the hot tub, and all but one of the blocks were red. This must be some sort of indicator to where I need to look in the lava. The only problem was the lava was still too far down to reach anything. This part seemed impossible until I realized I was missing something. I thought all of the items in my inventory were useless, but it turns out I actually had one useful item. If there was a button or pressure plate under this lava, I could actually use the fishing rod to activate it. So I tried casting my fishing rod, and sure enough, I heard a noise. The fishing rod had activated the dispenser, and a shulker was spawned. I let the shulker hit me with levitation, and I was carried to the next room. I walked down this long hallway, and I thought about the fact that over 99% of you are not subscribed. The next room contained a bunch of holes in the wall. Each hole had a hopper in it, with the exception of the top left, which had a boat. I also looked in F5 and found one of the holes had a crafting table. It was safe to say I needed to craft something in this room, so I dropped down. When I dropped down, I checked each hopper and they all contained 2 bamboo. I then made my way to the crafting table and checked the crafts. The only thing that you can make with bamboo is sticks, so I turned them all into sticks. After that, it was obvious that I had to make ladders. I used the ladders to climb up to where I saw the boat earlier and clicked the boat. I picked up the boat and found a chest in front of me. The chest had an iron ingot and that was it. I climbed up the staircase and I was back in the room I saw earlier. The only difference now is that I had both flint and an iron ingot, which means I could enter the nether. So I dropped down, lit the portal, and traveled to the nether. The portal brought me to a room full of barriers with a nether themed wall pattern behind it. There was also a beacon and some slabs that made a staircase to the top. I wouldn't be able to jump on these half slabs, so I needed to find a way to get up. Inside of this room, there was a beacon, which meant I could get jump boost if I had an ore. I remembered I still had the emerald that I was supposed to keep for later. So I used the emerald to get jump boost, and I climbed up the stairs. But you probably realized there was another way out. Instead, I could use the boat to climb up the half slabs. But I don't think this was intended, so I used the jump boost instead. At the top of the room, there was a big bedrock path leading to the exit of this prison. I went through the portal, and that was it. I had successfully escaped the prison.